Confederated Tribes of Grand Ronde, for all of you walkers, for the canoe family, for the people who came on horses. Thank you for doing that.
If you look around the country, the tribal nations, many of them live in places where the federal government thought that they would disappear, that they would not survive. Those nations have survived. So it's important that we remember that and that we remind the federal government of its federal trust relationship and responsibility to the Indian nations that they've signed treaties with. It's not something that was given to us. We are recognized as sovereign nations, and in that regard, we have an executive relationship, our tribal, our nation-to-nation relationship with the government of the United States. NCAI is probably the most effective lobby that we have in Indian country today.
If you look around here, what we're doing today, you see the building and all that stuff behind you, that's what we do. That's not who we are. The people you see here, the people around here in our traditional dress, that's who we are. We are Indian people, we're sovereign nations, and we'll be here forever.
As we step into the future, we have to remember that we're going to leave a path. We're going to make a path for the generations to follow. It's important that that's a good path, that the footprints that we leave honor those ancestors that came before us. They left a path for us. They made tremendous sacrifices for us to enjoy things that we enjoy today.
There's a lot of issues that we face back at home that we never think that another tribe's facing. But it all is with the same page, but just different areas. And I think it really inspires me that we can maybe sit down with this tribe or sit down with this organization to see what we can do to make it better.
This is an important time for us to come together, share ideas, look at how we can help one another. The whole purpose of NCAI is to work together to develop these relationships among our nations so that we can support each other. Many of these young people who come here to this conference are already leaders in their own communities. They're leading out of necessity, not because they can, but because they have to.